much as we can.
That's a good name. Like what made Trendsetter?
That's a tough one. And you know, I try to explain that to a lot of people, but I think it's just a lifestyle of growing up. You know, growing up in the neighborhood, we had everybody trying to make a name for themselves, and that was in general. Whether you know you were breakdancing, whether you're a graffiti artist, like everybody trying to make a name for themselves. Barbers, like. I really wanted to name my shop Ike's Barbershop a long time ago because, like I said, working on 290, it was like, oh, you live in the Heights? Like, that was a big deal. And they talked about it like it was a whole other community. And for me, it wasn't. So I was like, like, let's go with something more unique.
Right.
And I was like, oh, maybe the Blueprint, you know? Because the Blueprint is like, barbershop is the blueprint of a community, you know? You get married, go get your haircut, you know?
Yeah.
Job, go get your haircut. You know, everything is, it's a blueprint, you know? The haircut's a blueprint. But one of my buddies opened a shop called The Blueprint, so I was like, you can't shoot for that. You know, I don't want to step on his toes. And then everything else just sounded so corny.
Heights
Barbershop is cool. I mean, it just sounds too corporate. It wasn't us, you know?
Yeah.
And I don't know, man.
I think it would have blended in with every other Heights.
For sure, Well, back then, there was no Heights.
True.
Like, 8 years ago, nobody was doing what we were doing. Like, there was no barbershops in the Heights 8 years ago besides Doug's Barbershop, Studio Barbershop. I mean, those are literally pillars in the community.
Right.
Those things have been there for 35 years, and we respect that. And but
they won't do anything. Because it's kind of like, hey,
we're doing
it.
Yeah. Yeah. I love the name.
We just do our own thing. We're not worried about what everybody else is doing. We're not worried about the next guy's doing.
Like, it literally came from just growing up being us. Like I said, you know, being a b-boy, graffiti artist, whatever you were just trying to start a trend.
Yeah.
And we weren't really following other trends. We were just trying to start our own thing, you know.
And I love it. I love especially the fact that y'all were alumni from the same school. Shout out to Reagan High School.
Yeah, Reagan
High School. Now known as Heights High School, but we don't consider that the same.
Yeah, no. I would like an old school Reagan shirt. You know?
I still got my.
Part of my Hamilton gym shorts. Those things were small, but those are my speed now, you know?
Yeah, that's what you're going to sleep
in. Yeah.
But what I've always noticed that I think our high school was different in a lot of ways, you know?
It was a melting pot.
It was, and I feel like even though you had the goths, you had the music, you had the Elfrick, whatever.
All the kids with the spiky hair.
Yeah. We all still came down together, and even now I see it, and that was one of the main reasons why we started this podcast, was just from the get-go, our friends, our high school friends, you're doing your own thing.
Yeah, I got a lot to talk about.
I mean, whether it's bakery or a barber or like anything.
Yeah, there's a lot of business owners from Ray.
For sure.
It's funny you mentioned the fact that everybody was doing their own thing.
Yeah.
Shows you like where our mindset was, you know what I'm saying? Like everybody comes from the same place, so we know what we can say to the ground, you know what I mean? And I'm not necessarily saying like the Heights was it is now, because it definitely wasn't. You know, you had fucking crack houses on just about every corner, you know what I'm saying? Prostitutes walking the streets. Like it wasn't that good of a place to be.
Social.
You grow up in that, you know what I mean? Anybody who wants better for themselves is going to do what they have to do, you know what I'm saying?
I think a lot of that was a big way we weren't trying to compete with each other, you know? You know, in our own sense, we were, but we, you know, we just all kind of wanted to get ahead.
And you said you wanted to stand out.
Yeah, for sure. And I think that was a big thing. I was talking to somebody earlier about the same topic. I was like, man, you know, Waltrip High School had a lot of famous people coming out of Waltrip High School.
Right.
I was like, and you know, they're pretty known for that. I was like, Reagan, I was like, I don't know too many. I know, don't get me wrong.
I know a lot of losers who went to Reagan.
I do know a lot of, I do know a lot of entrepreneurs. Some good DJs that came out of Reagan, you know.
Yeah.
Some even construction work, man. A lot of people would look down on construction work, but those people make a lot of money, man. And it's a hard job to do. And you know, I considered doing construction work before I started cutting hair. My dad did it his whole life. He was a carpenter. Jesus was a carpenter. Hey, you know?